With faith and with elegance, the less. Thank you so much for joining me for coffee and tea. I have a treat for you. So, my cup says tea, but I'm having coffee. And I've taken a couple sips of my coffee already. How cute is that? I've shared this cup with you guys before. It says tea. So for those of you that don't like coffee, but love tea, I've got you today. I've got two for both. I've got the tea and the coffee. All right, I'm gonna take another sip and we can move on. So this is my tea coffee cup. So if this is your first time to my channel, welcome and thank you so much for choosing to watch this video. I'm excited because I'm excited every Tuesday. I get to spend this time with you guys, and I'm not kidding. I'm not just saying it. It's not just for camera. I truly am excited to be with you guys on Tuesdays. It gives me freedom to be able to sit back and not worry about, am I talking too much? Because that's what this channel is about right now. The Tuesday morning chit chat, coffee, tea, and my breakfast. Speaking of breakfast, I must tell you, I woke up this morning and I normally get up at 5 o'clock and then I fix breakfast and get my daughter and my husband off. And I woke up with this thought in mind this morning that I wanted some boiled eggs. I don't know why, but I wanted boiled eggs, tomatoes, bacon, and it was all in my mind. So, excuse me. And a cinnamon pastry. So I baked the pastry, boiled the eggs, and baked the bacon. And I thought, this is going to be a treat for you guys because normally I'm having a sandwich, but I didn't feel like that today. So I have bacon, eggs, boiled eggs, and I always have black pepper and salt on my boiled eggs and my tomato. Love tomato and boiled eggs together is amazing, guys. If you have not tried that, you should. It's very good. Really, really good. And then I have my grapes and I have cinnamon twist for, well, not twist, but a pastry for my dessert. Oh, if you're not a tomato lover, you may not care for it. I made it for my husband this morning as well, and he's like, don't send me with the tomato. I don't put it on my plate. I don't want it. He had to get it to go this morning because he had a men's Bible study he wanted to make, and he wanted to be on time. So this is my breakfast, and I feel so good because I don't have a cookie, but I have, let's get that out the way. It's healthy with a little treat. Okay, so I am really excited about today. I am going to share with you on faith. And yes, my name is Faithlyn. And every time I think of faith, I think of how powerful that is. First, I want to share with you that every single one of us have faith. I know that we sometimes may think, oh, you need more faith, or you don't have faith. But Jesus said that if we have a mustard seed of faith, we can move mountains. That faith will go forth and move mountains. And when you combine that with God knew us all before we were even formed in our mother's womb. He knew us before he created us. And then he formed us. So he knew us in our spiritual form. And he blessed us with everything we're ever going to need to be able to live on this earth. Then he formed us in our mother's womb, and here we are. So he equipped picked us before we even came into this earth. So we all have a measure of faith. And you may say, Faith, and how can you say that? We all have a measure of faith because I truly believe that God equipped us completely before we came into the earth. And because only faith can please God. God is moved by faith. And if He created us without faith, but expected us to display faith, that would not be a good God that we serve. And we know we serve a good God. So I truly, without a shadow of a doubt, know and believe that God equipped us before we came here on this earth. And He said He knew where we would live. He knew us before we were born. He knew where we would live. I think He has orchestrated our entire life, and we are moving and living out the manifestation of who we're supposed to become. Now, there are choices. There are two choices. There is God's choices, and there's our own choices that we decide to make. He decided He did not want to withhold from us free choice. So that's a gift that He gave to us. He has given us free choice. So even though He has a plan for our lives, this is God's plan, the direction He wants for us to go. We, because of rebellion, because of sin, want to choose our own path. So He has given us free will. Now, if we've chosen our own path, He knows how to get us back onto His plan. But at the same time, there are consequences for choosing our own path, our own plan that we have for our lives. Doesn't mean you're lost. Doesn't mean that it won't come back together. All things are possible with Christ. So therefore, the plans will come back together if you decide to turn away from your own plan and direct your sight, your heart, your faith on Christ. The plan will come back together. So I want to encourage you about faith today. Each and every single one of us have a measure of faith. Now, how is faith activated? Next week, I will share that with you. I truly believe there are four keys to activating faith. And I think about the woman with the issue of blood. And I scream every time. There is just something about this story. It shows you the power of faith, that God is moved by faith. We cannot be saved without faith. You cannot be saved and go to heaven to see the Lord and come back to the earth to live unless you have faith. And I may get some contradiction on that, but that is the word of God. There is one way to God, and it is through faith, through believing in His Son, our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ, and that is through faith, because we've never met Him, so we have to believe that He is real. And so next week, I will share with you what are those four keys that helps us experience what faith is. And when I think about that story of the woman with the issue of blood, for 12 years, and I know I'm going to tie my time up. I'm going to go over today, so I hope you guys enjoy this video to where you stick in there to watch it. But I can't help but share with you guys the story with the woman with the issue of blood. This woman had a problem for 12 years, bleeding uncontrollably. Every doctor she's gone to, no one can help her. She has lost all her money to seeking help with this from different doctors. Her families couldn't live with her anymore, because in those days, when you're bleeding vaginally, you're bleeding, it's unclean. And so being unclean, you can't touch anything that other people are going to use. And so no one can be around her. But she heard about this man. She heard about a man who, no matter where he goes, he heals people. Except for, and this is how powerful faith is, because the scripture tells us that Jesus Christ, our Lord and Savior, who knows all things, who can do anything and everything. There isn't anything too hard for our God, our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. But because, the scripture tells us, because of unbelief, Jesus could not do miracles. That blows me away. Every time I read that, it blows me away. The God of the universe, who created everything, could not perform, miracles because of lack of faith. That's how powerful faith is. So going back to the story, the woman heard about this man who heals every time. He could only heal a few people in this particular city because they didn't believe. It's where he was born. And they're like, that's Mary's boy. We know his sisters. We know his brothers. It's not like he's this educated, you know, doctor or have any type. He's the carpenter's boy. And normally back then, your child or your children takes on, the son takes on the profession that you have. So they knew him, so they wouldn't believe that he is the Messiah. But this woman heard, and she believed. And she was desperate because she's been everywhere for 12 years and nothing would happen. She heard about this man who would come to her city that day. And she's like, I'm going to make my way there. I'm going to go see this man because this is my last hope. Can't have my family around. Everyone scorns me because I'm unclean. And when you walk, you have to say unclean so people know they need to move out your way. This woman got to the crowd and she saw Jesus. She decided she wanted to make her way through the crowd to go and see this man that she believed, and she truly believed, was the only one that could give her what she could not have gotten in 12 years. And so she had to crawl on her belly. She had to crawl. And how do you know she crawled? Because she could only touch the hem of his garment. And back then you have to get very low because you are unclean. So she made her way there and she said, I have to touch him. I have to get what he has. And she went and touched the hem of his garment, believing that she would be healed. The scripture says, the moment she touched it, power left Jesus, touched the woman's body, and healed her instantly because of her faith. This woman did not ask permission. This woman did not let anyone know she was around. She touched her hem because she believed. She had faith that this would happen, and it healed her. Scripture says right away, Jesus felt the power leaving his body. And he says, who touched me? The disciple says, how can you ask that question, who touched you, when there's so many people around us? And he says, I know someone touched me because I felt power leaving my body. And the woman confessed. And this is what Jesus did. He sealed it with just the word. He says, woman, you are now made whole. And that's what many of us need, to be made whole. Our faith is there. We may not know how to activate our faith. We need to activate our faith and then let God make us whole. I wanted to share that with you guys today. I hope that is a blessing to you today. I know it's been in my spirit for 2 days, so I know someone needs this message today. And I wanted to share it with you guys, even though my video is going to go over today. But I hope that it blessed you. I hope you will share with me that it was a blessing to you. And next week, I will tie it all up with how do you activate the power of faith, because we all have a measure of faith. We've all been given the power of faith. We've been given everything we need to be successful. God said, I've given you the power to get wealth. I've given you the power to be healed. Choose to live in the kingdom of God, which Jesus Christ brought back to the earth when he came to die for our sins, to set us free so we can have freedom and liberty to celebrate who we are in him. So with that said, I thank you so much, and I'm going to share my bye with you guys quickly so that we can wrap this up. So I went to Bell's. Now you guys have seen the other two that I've purchased. I love these things. They are an example of the ones that Z Gallery has. Z Gallery is plain, but I love this one because it has the detail. And I do have a video where I've recreated it. But I decided that I wanted a third one. So I went to Bell's and they were clearanced them out. They clearanced them out for $12.49. Now keep in mind, I purchased it when it first came out and it was $24.99. I didn't care because I really loved it and wanted it. But now I'm ecstatic that I'm able to get the third one for $12.49. Yeah! Then, I was in love with this for a while and it wouldn't go down. They have another one and I'm thinking I'm gonna go and haul it. So Bell's had these for $11.89. Clearanced it out. So I thought, it's for me, because I've been wanting it for so long. So I was blessed with that. I'm ecstatic. Of course, you know, I get asked this question all the time about this candle. I have 12 of them. I bought them from Michael's. They are $7.99 and you can use a coupon on it. 40% or 50%, whatever they're running at the time. But they are fabulous. I love the detail. You can recreate them too if you want it. It's pretty simple. But I want to thank you guys so much for joining me today. I went way over, but I hope that you will spend this time giving me your feedback. I love communicating with you guys. And I'm just so appreciative of your time and your support. Thank you guys, and I will see you later on today for a DIY. All right, have a blessed afternoon.